the slides which have shown to you that is the key points about the life in city. Here I am going to relate those information with your textual content right now. Harappan city was a very busy city. People who planned the construction of special buildings in the city, they were probably the rulers. The rulers sometimes sent people to distant lands to get metal, precious stones and other things that they wanted. They kept the most valuable objects with them, such as ornaments of gold and silver and beautiful beads, which has been discovered by the archaeologist. There were another type of people who were living over there, like scribes. What is the meaning of scribe? The people who knew how to write. They helped prepare the seals and perhaps wrote on other materials that have not survived. From these para, you are getting two questions. First, that the city life of the people of Harappan sites. Here you can see the rulers are actually playing the vital role to take any kind of decision. They are constructing building for their own purpose. For their own collection, they are sending people to the distant lands as if that was their possession. And the scribes who knew how to write, they also prepared these seals and wrote on other material. So this is the second question, that is, who are scribes? People who knew how to write. I already marked over here. You also write down the same in your school copy. Next part, beside them, there were men and women who were very, very proficient about the craft work. They are making all kind of things. Maybe it is in their own homes or in a special workshops. That was very frequently found evidence or the common features most of the Harappan sites during the time of third stage of Harappan civilization. People were traveling distant lands or returning with raw materials and perhaps some of the time stories also. So many terracotta toys have been found. That means the terracotta toys are also being made by these craft persons that can be used as a playing object for the children. Now you write down one question, that is, make a list of the people who lived in the city. The answer will be the rulers, obviously. Then the next part, it will be traders, scribes, craft persons, travelers, priests, etc. Now I am coming to the next part. You can see the picture of one seal and some of the terracotta toys. Over the seal, some scripts which were written. They are using the signs. So that is the earlier form of writing known in the subcontinent. Later on, scholars have tried to read this sign, but we still do not know exactly what they mean. And the next picture was terracotta toys. Now children, move to the next slide. That slide will give you the brief idea about that craft work, which are actually the main and distinctive feature of Harappan sites, in a nutshell. So go through the slide and once again we will relate it with your textual reference and relevant questions. Some of the objects that were made and found in Harappan cities, those are the stone weights, beads, stone blades, embroidered cloth, stone statues, and so on. Most of the things which have been found in archaeologists by the archaeologist are made of stone, shell and metal, and that is including copper, bronze, gold and silver. Copper and bronze were used to make tools, weapons, ornaments, vessels. Gold and silver were used to make ornaments and vessels. Perhaps the most striking finds are those of beads, weights and blades. You can see some of the pictures of that findings from different Harappan sites. That is the ornament, then stone weights. You can see the picture it has given in your text also. The Harappan also made seals out of stone. These are generally rectangular and usually have an animal carved on them. The Harappans also made pots with beautiful back design, such as the one shown on page number 6. Next, another question as given in your textbook, that was metal used in the villages? You learned about chapter 2? No, that metals were not being in use during that time. That villages, it is referring the early villages. So from here we are having the clear idea, the Harappan civilization was far ahead of its time. Finally, another finding discovered or explored by the archaeologists, that is cotton, the use of cotton. Cotton was probably grown at Mehergarh from about 7000 years ago. Actual pieces of cloth were found attached to the lid of a silver vase and some copper objects at Mohenjo-daro. That was the finding. Archaeologists have also found spindle holes, which is made of terracotta and faience. Faience is a special kind of thing. I am going to explain it later on. These were used to spin thread. It's a kind of tools, or the you can say like a machine nowadays. Now, what is faience? Unlike stone or shell that are found naturally, faience is a material that is artificially produced. A gum was used to shape sand or powdered quartz into an object. The objects were then glazed, resulting in a shiny, glassy surface. The colors of the glaze were usually blue or sea green. Faience was used to make beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels. You can see the picture. This is the example or the evidence of faience. Now I am coming to the next part, that is I already referred about the craft persons who were specialist. Many of the things that were produced were probably the work of specialist. A specialist is a person who is trained to do only one kind of work. For example, cutting tools or polishing beads or carving seals. I can assure you about this particular finding that who are those specialists? They were proficient about their own work. And that's why during the time of Harappan sites, in different Harappan sites, so many specialized items can be found. Now, one picture has given in your book, that is in page number 28. Previous page we already have discussed about that. The illustration was very nice. How well the face is curved and how carefully the beard is shown. It is the sculpture or the statue of a man. These must have been the work of an expert craft person. Everybody not yet a specialist. We really don't know whether only men were specialists or only women were specialists. Perhaps some women and men may have been specialists. So here you are getting some questions. That questions are mainly you need to write that what kind of metals are being used to prepare different kind of objects. I already marked. And what are the uses of copper and bronze? Then what is the use of gold and silver? How it has been used on the object or by the craft person? And weight, that the weight, the stone weights is the most interesting use, or the use of stone weights. Carefully and precisely these weights are shaped. From this particular portion under new crops in the city, so here you can be, you will be having another question that what type of crafts work are being done by the people of Harappa, and what are the major findings of Harappan from Harappan sites? How can a people, an archaeologist, are quite sure about the use of cotton, because that statue is giving that evidence. Now from this page you are getting another question, that is faience. What is faience? You need to write in the blue box whatever the information has given. And then the another question, the who were known as specialists, that also I have discussed. But here also one confusion which archaeologists are having, that is, this, these specialists, are they women or men, or both of them have participated or engaged in this kind of activity? Now, we already have referred about a lot of craft materials of Harappan site. Here, the next part is coming in search of raw materials, because when you are preparing all those things, that raw materials are very much needed. Raw materials are substances that are either found naturally, like wood, ores or metal, or produced by farmers or herders. So here you are getting the what is called or what are called as raw material. These are then processed to produce finished good. The same way, nowadays also you are getting raw material from different natural sources, and then we are changing its form and making new things. Like cotton produced by farmer is the raw material, and that may be processed due to make cloth. Some of the raw materials that the Harappan used were available locally. But many items such as copper, tin, gold, silver and precious stones had to be brought from distant lands or the places. Here you will be getting another question, that what are the raw materials are being used and from where they are getting all those things. From where they are getting this all things as raw material, that place is also referred very nicely. Harappan probably got copper from present-day Rajasthan. Please underline this portion. And even from Oman, they are also getting this copper. It is in West Asia. Tin, which was mixed with copper to produce bronze, may have been brought from present-day Afghanistan. So tin is is actually coming from Afghanistan and Iran. Gold could have come all the way from present-day Karnataka and the precious stones from present-day Gujarat, Iran, and Afghanistan. So here, another important question, from where the raw materials are being collected, name the places. You can see the picture of one seal. Can you hear another question as you will get that what type of transport used by the Harappans? As you know, the Harappan civilization, most of the sites flourished beside the river bank. So the waterways are being used as the mode of communication, and they are going to that distant land by these waterways only. Today we will discuss about the content about the life in a city, the people who are living over there, and then what are the different kind of activities they are doing, and finally we are getting the question, the information about the different kind of artifacts or the different kind of art that specialized work which were very famous in Harappan sites. So from where this kind of things are being made, and from where the raw materials are coming, and what kind of communication they might be using to bring all this thing. So today, up to this part, I will be coming very short span of a time with my next in my next video about the closer look of Harappan towns in Gujarat, that is Dholavira and Lothal, and about the food habits of people in these cities. That means what kind of agricultural works are being done and what are the tools are being used. Regarding all, I am going to discuss in detail in my previous, in my next video. You please go through the last portion of this video upload, where you will be getting some questions, and those questions I already marked as well as referred in detail. You write down all the question answer, probable question answer from this chapter, from this part specifically, in your school copy, and then you send it to me through my mail. And do remember, whenever you are sending your work, that must be given in PDF format. So you need to use Adobe Scanner or this kind of app which can convert your copies at the time of sending mail into PDF format. So children, up to this for today, learn this thing nicely. And extra question answer will be provided through Word file in the school website on time. Until then, stay happy, stay tuned with my channel, and wait for the next slide. Goodbye.